Hi and hello, I am Athena Pontin here. Welcome to the basics of biomedical classroom once again. Today we are going to discuss about the basics of basic vital parameter signal, that is ECG. So what is ECG and how this particular ECG is measured and what is the dimensions of all this ECG, everything we are going to discuss today. Come, let me start the class now. ECG. So what are the things we are going to discuss today is, what is ECG, what is ECG waveform, what is the dimensions, that is amplitude and the time duration of that particular waveform, how the waveform is generated and how the waveform is measured. So these are all the 5 questions we have. So we need to answer these 5 questions. Here the first question is, what is ECG? Electrocardiography is a process of producing electrocardiogram. It is a graphical representation of voltage versus time of the electrical activity of the heart that is produced by the electrodes placed on the skin. So please remember, electrocardiography, it is also represented in the way of ECG or EKG. Okay, so electrocardiography is a process of producing electrocardiogram. Electrocardiogram is nothing but the waveform signal. It is the graphical representation between the voltage and the time, voltage versus time. Okay, so this particular voltage versus time gives the electrical activity of the heart. Electrical activity of the heart, we can place some of the electrodes over the skin of the human body. So this is how we can able to answer electrocardiography. The second question is waves. Of course, I already told you, it is a graphical representation of between the voltage and the time. Okay, it is a graphical representation of voltage versus time. Here, voltage, it is in the, it represents the y-axis and it is indicated in the x-axis time. Then, PQRST waveform. So, PQRST waveform indicates some of the waveform signal. So, how it is waveform indicates that? See? So this is the representation of one PQRST waveform. What is that PQRST waveform? This amplitude section is P, this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T, and this is U. It is mentioned in the capital itself. So please remember, we already know that is a graphical representation between the voltage versus time. Here, waveform is nothing but some of the indication of up and downs. So, this is the ECG waveform, one ECG waveform. This is P, Q, R, S, T and U. So, this is the ECG waveform, PQRST waveform or EKG waveform. So, this is the clear view of PQRST waveform. So, we already discussed in the graphical graph itself. Here, we need to take PR interval. PR interval is very important, and QRS complex interval is very important, and the thing is QT interval is also important. One more thing, QT is interval. So the doctors, they want to analyze the heart of the patient, they are going to measure what is the PR interval, what is the QRS interval and what is the QT interval. Then now we are going to discuss about what is the amplitude and the time duration range of this waveform. See, first of all, just take a P. This particular P, it attains the time duration, it is 0.12 second, please remember. Its time duration is around 0.12 seconds. Okay, then this particular QRS, the hole, it starts from Q and ends towards the S. This QRS complex attains the time duration of around 0.10 seconds. Please remember. And then this particular T attains the time duration of 0.15 seconds. So this is the variations you need to note. Then come to the amplitude. Here P attains the amplitude of 2.5 mm. In the QRS, R attains the maximum amplitude in the peak RST waveform. So this particular R attains less than or equal to 7.5 mm. So this particular QRS can be varied by each and every person to person. According to the heart activity, this particular R amplitude, it may be vary for different person to person. So please remember, approximately it is less than 7.5 mm amplitude. And then this particular T is less than or equal to 2.5 mm. So this is the time duration and the amplitude of peak RST waveform. According to this particular amplitude, the voltage will arise. Okay. So this particular thing is very important. You keep on remember, using this particular time duration only, we can able to understand the heart activity clearly. Now we are going to discuss about the next question, how this ECG waveform, that is peak RST waveform, is generated. Okay, come let me see. We just recall the function of the heart first of all. Okay, just see this. I just put a free body sketching of heart first of all. So here, these two are auricles, and here the bottom region we have two ventricles. Okay. Here we know that there is a sinoatrial node is present, of course. Sinoatrial node is the natural pacemaker. From there itself, the natural pulses will generate it. That's all, of course, you know that. Then here we have auriculoventricular node. Okay, auriculoventricular node. And here all this particular and auriculoventricular node will be split into the Purkinje system in the ventricles. So that is, we have discussed in the function of the heart itself. Here, what we are going to discuss is how this P waveform is generated first of all. See, once the natural pulses is generated here in the sinoatrial node, this particular pulses generation is transferred to the auriculoventricular node. During the time, the cells present in the auricles, please remember, every organ is made up of tissue and every tissue consists of so many cells. So cells that is present in the auricles been excited. Okay, because of the cell excited, that is cell excited means that the cell membrane potential, it's got excited and it attained the more positive state. Okay, so during the excitation process, this signal transformation, because of the signal transformation, that is pulses transformation from sinoatrial node to the auriculoventricular node, the cells of the auricle getting excited, because of that, the depolarization of the auricles attain. Depolarization is defined as changes in the cell membrane potential to move positive state. Okay, that is because of the force attained in the auricles, the normal cell membrane potential will get excited. So the depolarization occurs, so it attains the amplitude like this, it attains some of the voltage, that is P. Okay, then the next is, after P, then this QRS complex is always generated. See, once the auriculoventricular node receives the pulses from the sinoatrial node, after the contraction of the auricles, this particular pulses in the auriculoventricular node need to transfer the pulses to the ventricles. Okay, during the initial condition, once it reaches in the fraction of second before it reached the ventricles, it attains the negative pulses because the cell membrane potential is slowed down. Okay, then once it reaches the ventricles fully, the walls of the ventricle is very thicker, we know that. So the pressure creation is also higher. So the cells present in the ventricles, it get more excited than that of the auricles. So after the pulse will reaches to the ventricles, the excitation is more. So the depolarization of the ventricles occurs. Because of this particular depolarization of the ventricles, this QRS will be generated. How this particular T wave is generated? See, this particular T is generated because of the repolarization of the auricles. Once the process is getting over, again the pulses start generating in the sinoatrial node. During that time, the repolarization occurs. After the depolarization got over, then the repolarization of the auricles starts. During that time, the T wave attains some of the voltage. So this is the process of ECG warm generated. So how the P wave generated, how the QRS generated, and how the T wave generated. Okay, this is the one waveform. If you want to study the electrical activity of the heart, we need the continuous monitoring of the patient. The continuous ECG waveform, that is PQRST, PQRST, PQRST. Then only we can able to understand the equal rhythm of each and every waveforms. Okay, so that is the thing. The question is got over. That is how the ECG waveform is generated. This is the process of generating ECG waveform. The next question is how this ECG waveform is a measure. See, we already in the definition itself says that electrical activity of the heart can be studied by placing electrodes over the skin. There are so many electrodes out there. Electrodes are just like a transducer. It is acquiring this signal because this ECG waveform is acquiring minimum voltage because action potential is very minimum. So if you want to acquire that particular minimum voltage, we need a transducer that will pick the signal from your body. Okay, so the placement of electrodes, where we can able to place the electrodes? We can able to place the electrode in the chest because of the heart is present here. And also we can able to place your electrodes in the arms and the leg. Why we can able to place the arms and the leg? Because the pulse is generated. According to the pulse rate, we can able to generate the ECG waveform also. But chest electrodes gives the accurate reading of ECG waveform. That is very important. Okay, so if in case, if you want to measure this particular ECG waveform, we need to follow the Eindhoven triangle rule. Eindhoven is a scientist who introduced the triangle called the Eindhoven triangle. This is purposely for how we can able to place your electrodes in the arms. This is the triangle. This is the rough triangle of Eindhoven. Okay, so here, these three are considered as lead 1, lead 2 and lead 3. Okay, leads are nothing but the lead systems. We can able to measure the voltage difference between these leads, voltage difference between these leads and voltage difference between these leads. Okay, so here this is a right arm, this is a left arm and this is a left leg. Please remember. Okay, so we need to place the electrodes in the way of like this. Right arm, we need to place a clamp electrode. The left arm, we need to place a clamp electrode. In the left leg, we need to place the clamp electrode. Each and every lead systems give some of the voltage difference. According to that, we can able to study the electrical activity of the heart for framing the ECG also. So, using this Eindhoven triangle, we can able to place the electrodes in the arms and the legs. Or if you are not following this Eindhoven triangle, we just go for the chest electrode. We can able to place the chest electrodes in the particular region of your ribs. According to that, the waveform will be generated. Rather, this particular lead system, that chest electrode will give the accurate reading of this particular PQRST waveform. Okay, so this is the question, how the ECG is measured. Okay, using the Eindhoven triangle lead systems, we can able to measure, or we can able to use the chest electrode to acquire the ECG waveforms. So this is the small description about ECG waveform. So that's all about this today's class. We are studying about the small description about ECG, what is ECG and how we can able to measure and what is the studies required for framing that PQRST waveform, all the things. So we are just hold this topic today. Then the next class, we are going to see the next vital parameter, EMG. Thank you very much.